right now that you're in students, that's why I'm addressing you guys, because you're students. Think why you're different. Think how can you improve your online presence if that's what you want. Think how can you do something that later on in 2 years somebody is going to call you in VIT to tell your experience. So be that person. So, I amazing Shivam, because I actually never sat for my placements, because I was like, key placements with the companies come, they are looking for software engineers. And I know that I am not just any software engineer, because I improved myself. I have made myself, I've given myself a title that I am going to be working on app development only, because I have worked so many years on this. Why should I just go for some software engineering, right? Unless they're mentioning that they're actually working on an app, I did not even sit for any placements. My teachers were very pissed on that, but I was like, I will get some job, I know, even if it takes a year, I will improve myself till that time. And I know for some people it will not be something, because you have to like support your family, you support the finances. Definitely think about that, how you can you support your finances right from today, rather than ki wo placement mein meko paise milenge. I know a lot of you are aiming for high CGPAs, and you're like, you want to learn all the technologies, right, which is famous right now, so that you can show a great resume. But I think if placements and jobs and resume is the only reason why you're doing everything today, I think you're missing the point there. Like, you need to have a passion for doing all this. Like, if you are, like the people who talked about doing painting and doing playing the bagpipe, and you know, you are definitely passionate for doing that, and that you enjoy doing that. And if you're not enjoying development, or you're not enjoying ML, AI, or you're not enjoying today's technology that you just like signed up for, I think it may not, you may get a great resume where like, oh, I attended a workshop, I attend XYZ conference and all that, but where is the passion? Like if you, how are you different from other people here? Like today we have like around 90 people in this audience. How are you different from all the other people? What are you doing differently? I mean, how would you ever, if you do the same thing as other people, how would you ever come to coach a VIT and tell about your experience? I mean, you definitely have to do something different in your college. And this is a great time. This is a great time to actually learn things that you have to enjoy. If you're not enjoying, quit. Like, don't quit like the second day, but try for like at least a month, 6 months, 7 months. And then also you don't enjoy it, maybe you have to go to the next thing that you like. And even today, when I can say in college, I did so many things like web development, and it was like so crazy. Web development at that point in time was like very famous. There were so many frameworks, and I tried all that, but I really did not like it. It was not fun for me to do web dev. So I thought, let me go back to Android, which I like. Why should I risk that the things that I like? So I started doing more app development because of it, and I am so happy that I went with something that I like rather than something famous. That time web development was famous. That time I did not go with that. ML was famous that time. I did not go with that. I mean, I have made apps with ML capabilities, but that does not mean that I'm completely focused on that. And also I'm bad at maths, so I did not go with them. But definitely that was something that I wanted to like put out there, that you need to love this. If you're doing Flutter, try it for like months, like 3-4 months, 5 months, 6 months. Even then you're like, oh my god, this is so boring, I can't do this. Then trust me, even if you get a job in Flutter, you will never like it, and that's something that you don't want to do. So that's one thing that I really wanted to put it out there, because as a college student, I was like a few years back, I know how people think in college. I know that everyone is like talking about placements. How many of you are doing Flutter for placements? Like, I would actually do a anonymous poll here. It's okay. So we have like around till now we have around like 25-26% yes that they are doing this Flutter for placements and jobs, which is completely fine because you are thinking about your placements and jobs. But if that's the only reason, you will be disappointed, because how placements work, they will not come like, I want a Flutter developer from your college. They will not come with that. They are going to come like, I want software engineers or something. You will never know what company, what work you're doing in that company unless you join that company. They are going to go for software engineers. So you're never going to find such companies who come for placements and like they say, I want Flutter developers. That's not going to happen. Not at least not here. Like, but it took a long time to even to college to come to like, I want Android developer. That was also a long time. Otherwise, before that, it was like, I want some IT. I want software engineer. Like, software engineer who can do any sort of thing. But yeah, I'm a tier 3 college with bad placement record. Can you advise something about off-campus placements? Off-campus placements, the best thing that can work for you is online presence. If you are not having your online presence, how will the companies know what you're doing? And what if they want to actually invite you for an interview? How would they? If you're completely off the grid, right? So what I did is like by the fourth year, third year or something, I actually like filled my, I joined Twitter. And I think that is why I got into like the Flutter community also, because of Twitter, because I was talking to a lot of people from the Flutter community and the Flutter team. So that was great. And then LinkedIn, I was very active on LinkedIn by that point of time. I was like sharing everything that I was doing. Like I won this competition, I won that competition, like tell without any kind of like hesitance, just tell what you're doing. Like even if you're currently in Hasnan's workshop, go and tell in your social media, whatever platform you have, that I am attending this workshop. And I am learning great things, and let people know that this person is interested in this technology. At one point, they might start noticing, okay, you are actually sharing a lot on Flutter. Oh, if I have a Flutter job, why don't I just ask you for an interview? Okay, that's one thing. LinkedIn is a very good place to actually get connections, but also Twitter. I don't know about any other platform. They don't work as well for leads. But offline, off-campus placements, you need good online presence so that once you have applied, you can just show that, okay, I am available in so many places. So definitely the interviewer is going to like, okay, maybe he or she actually looks like something that they know things. They are not like any other student who are just, you know, doing CGPA and then doing internal projects, that's it, or doing that. Same projects as other students are doing. They're doing something different. So online presence is the key if you want offline, off-campus placements. Any advice for tier 3 college students to get into big tech companies? Why big tech companies? Whoever said that they are aiming for Google, why? What is Google doing today is so amazing that you just want to aim for Google only. Like, definitely the tag. Again, you're going for that tag, the label that Amazon will lay off. Google, Amazon, Flipkart, etc. But what, like, there are so many people already there in that software engineering department of Amazon, Google. Again, how will you be different between them? You have to think, like, if there are like 100 developers in Google, what, even if you get into Google, you have to like really, really shine to just be like sustaining that job. But again, that you can be that, of course, you can be amazing and actually be in Google. Definitely aim for it, but just don't aim for Google. Aim for something like, what if actually if you get rejected in Google at one point of time, you're going to be very disappointed. But so have some other kind of a goal, like, you know, that I want to be in a company that is working on XYZ and can sustain my family in this kind of finances. They can give me the salary. Okay, it's fine. A little bigger. Think bigger, because a lot of startups are also giving the same kind of opportunities and same kind of things that Google does. So, yeah. Okay. One easy question. Have you ever met Sundar Pichai? I have not like met him, like shook our hands or something. But I have met him from a distance when we went to Google I.O. So I'm like really sad because one of my friends actually took a photo with him. And I was like, shit, I was not with her at that point of time. So I would have also got a picture or something like that. So yeah, I have not met him, but I have seen him live in Google I.O. from a distance or something like that. So yeah, that's the only thing that I can brag about. When I was talking about the community that had started, I wanted to, as I said, I wanted to be a little different and do some things that helps my knowledge. Like, I had two agenda. I want to increase my knowledge so that I'm better at least answering questions or something. And I wanted to have an online presence. Definitely, that's something that I really had to attend agendas. Yeah, so I did a workshop and I was like on stage teaching people. And that where I actually realized that, okay, this is great. I actually like teaching a lot. And that reminds me, when I was like 10 years old, I always wrote in my slam book that I want to be a teacher. Okay. And today, whatever I do, Medium articles or YouTube or like speak at events, I am still teaching. I'm so happy that I made my 10-year-old proud by sticking to what she said at 10-year-old. And then that's when I started writing Medium articles. So I was writing Medium articles when I started that community. I was attending also hackathons. So I was like writing about Firebase. I was writing about design and technology, etc., etc. And even at that point of time, there was no like, it was not that viral like my Flutter articles. Like I just got like 10 views or 15 views and like 1-2 claps, that's all. 17 is when I started writing my Medium articles. And it my first Medium article that got famous was only in 2018 end. So it took me 1.5 years to actually get that online presence that I wanted. So if you're thinking that if you will start something today and you're going to get that recognition right away in 2 months, it is not going to be that easy. Imagine I wrote my first application that was like 4 years before that. So if today I'm like whatever I have got, whatever recognition I've got, it actually took me around 6-7 years in that case, right? And even if people, I know a lot of people will say, and when they are giving this tips, they will say that college is a very young place. You don't have to think about your future right now. I'm not asking you to think about the future because I also don't know what is going to happen to me at 1 year later. But you need to prepare for the future that you want. You can't be like, "Arey, college ko ekdam mast me spend and then I'll somehow like get a job and then I'll earn in lakhs and millions." I'm like, "Bhai, kahan se hoga ye?" If you don't work, you need to work for it, right? And college is a great time to start thinking on this because once you start jobs, and if you're at the wrong job already, it will be hard to get out of that comfort zone because every month you get salary and you don't want to like quit at that point of time to get something better. It's very hard during jobs. So right now that you're in students, that's why I'm addressing you guys, because you're students. Think why you're different. Think how can you improve your online presence if that's what you want. Think how can you do something that later on in 2 years somebody is going to call you in VIT to tell your experience. So be that person. How to overcome the fear of speaking in public. As I said, I still am scared a bit, right? Like right now, not so much, but whenever I go on the stage or like even I'm starting a virtual workshop or any kind of speaking event, like literally thang, 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 thang. So I have that, like oh my God, what if I just like blank out? And that has happened. What if people ask me questions that I cannot answer? Because imposter syndrome to hai. So if you feel like, okay, oh shit, I just became an expert, now they're gonna ask me like such expert questions that I will not be able to answer them. That happens today also. Like I don't know everything, I can't. And I think one person, Varun, you must have asked Hasan also, that do you need to know everything as a developer and do you need to remember everything as a developer? Absolutely not. Like as Hasanen said, that we always like look at the documentation. I look at Stack Overflow documentation and like even like look at other people's work and see like, oh my god, I can actually implement it this way. I didn't know. I learned something today. So I look a lot at people's work as well. I learn from documentation. I learn from Stack Overflow. I do all of that. Even today, I will not be able to like, without preparation, I don't do any workshop. I know because I have to prepare something. I mean, I don't know, Hasan, you must have also like did some preparation, right? Like, you know, like, are aaj to... That's the workshop. Let me just start something today. Like, yeah, guys, this is the Flutter thing. You can do like this. No, I'm pretty sure that everyone does some work preparation and they have materials ready. We are always scared because we don't want to give you wrong information, right? We want to be sure of what information we are giving, because at one point of time, if you come up and say that, hey, you, whatever you said, that was wrong. I'm like, yeah, because I just woke up from sleep and gave you the workshop. That's why it was wrong. I mean, there's a lot of preparation we do. So about getting the fear of speaking, overcoming that, I think you have to just start doing a lot of public speaking. At one point of time, it's going to get reduced. Like the fear is going to get reduced. The first time it's going to like, I think your blood pressure is going to be like off the roof, but, after a point of time, it will get reduced and you will need at least 5 bad performances or 5 bad events before you get to the good one. I want to start my own startup with my friends. So what can I do for it? I don't know like the process of starting a startup, but there's another thing. Don't think that you need to start a startup because it's famous or something interesting to do, because I know I have also done this, but like before even going to college first year, I knew that I was going to join the entrepreneurship cell of the college because startups are the thing. So I will start my own startup at my college. I'll be going to be great. But unless you have the idea, unless you have the breaking idea, it doesn't make sense to start a startup, right? And it doesn't have like, you have to be a registered company right from the day you get your idea. Work on your idea. Make the app, the website. Make the resources ready for the idea. Get people, get customers, get users. And at one time, you will see it has automatically converted into a startup. And people are like now you need to be registered and all that. And that will eventually happen. So aim for the idea. Find that idea in your daily things, and maybe you will actually find the startup at one point of time. So yeah, start looking for the idea. Okay, I think we are done here. I can't take any more questions. Thank you so much. You've been an amazing audience, and shameless plug, do subscribe to my channel. Looks like the only thing I gained during quarantine is weight. I mean, yeah, sure.
That is for everyone.